So I've been playing around with the new features in Photoshop, and I discovered a little hack for color grading. I think you're really going to like this, and I know you've never seen it before. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to set this up, and no, it's not gradient maps, but check this out. We're going to choose Window, and we're going to go under our Gradients panel. Now, what you want to do is make sure you've got Photographic Toning. Click on the edge here, choose Legacy Gradients. That will load in the Legacy Gradient group. Then under Legacy Gradients, what you're going to do is go down to Photographic Toning. Excellent. Let's just drag this out, make a little grid. Now what you're going to do is take a screen capture of this. So that's Shift-Command-4 on the Mac. And we're just going to drag around this color panel. Now on Windows, I believe you hit Print Screen. Or maybe there's another way to do it. Someone can drop a comment there because I'm on Mac. But what you're doing is taking a screen capture. Right. Now, get ready for this. We're going to hit Control J or Command J. We're going to duplicate that layer. And we're going to turn it into a smart object. So right click and convert to a smart object. All right, so we're going to choose Filter. We're going to get onto the Neural Filters. And you think you've seen this before, but hold on. Let's going to choose Color Transfer. Now, if it hasn't downloaded, see the little cloud icon, click on that little cloud, download it, and we're going to turn it on. Now, you might have seen this before. You can go in and choose these different things and apply the color tone from these different images to your image. All right, this is not what we're going to do, though. Let's go under Custom. Now, under Custom, you can select your own image, but this is where my cool hack came in. I was like, what if I use a reference image using a gradient. But wait, this is applying all the gradients. There's a couple more steps. What if we just choose one gradient? So I'm going to click and drag and just apply this one gradient. Okay, now it's applying a color tone. It's a little strong, right? Let's go down and change to preserve luminosity. Okay, definitely getting there. It's not quite there yet, but check this out. With output set to smart filter, which is going to be anyway because we're working on a smart object, click OK. Now, change this blend mode from normal to color. And what we're going to do is just adjust the opacity all the way down. So there's the original tone and then start to mix it with the new tone. So we've got about 50% there. We're not done yet. This is where it really gets good. So see where it says neural filters, double click. It's going to go back into our neural filter panel. And it's going to process. It's going to, you know, do its thing. Turn off preserve luminance because we don't need that anymore. And notice this. We can actually drag on here so we don't have to create a new one and we can go to the different gradients. Now watch what happens. As we click on the new one, not only is it applying a new gradient, but it's showing us with the layers, with the color blend mode, and the result of reducing the opacity. So this is actually what our final result's going to be like. So now these are much more usable. And we can just drag our little square or create a new one around different gradients, each one producing an entirely different result. This is different than what you're going to get for gradient map or color overlays. And then when you're happy, just click OK to apply it. And if we look at this, here's the before and here's the after. If it's a little strong, you can still adjust that opacity. So I'm curious, guys, what do you think about that? Have I stumbled upon a useful technique? Let me know in the comments underneath. And by the way, if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Great to have you with us. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. So one of the things I like to do is fool around inside of Photoshop, experiment and come up with exciting new things. And I'm sure that, you know, someone will probably copy this in a week or so. But anyway, guys, if you got any value out of this, do me a favor, hit that like button. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.